Idle hands become mischievous hands in Mordor.
Which is why I'm glad to see them. So busy.
Have seen a spider's web, strung with dew? That is the web of fate. All possibilities hang in the balance, but as the sun rises and the wind blows, the dewdrops fall, and history is revealed. A dark lord or a bright one?
Visions reveal the truth. All of them. What say you?
Truth? I used to believe in truth. But it is a corrupted virtue in the hands of those like Shelob and Sauron.
You will obey!
Going on 10, I'm on the arc.
Yeah.
The glitchiness on some of this shit is ridiculous. Just let me climb, dammit.
Ubolgond Henle Edreget.
My earliest memories are of being nestled under blankets as my mother showed me the illustrations in a storybook about Loki the Larrikin, whose mischief always ended in disaster, though she was always one step ahead of her stern governess. I found the book tucked away years later after I learned to read, and I was surprised to learn that the storybook was full of little morality plays, not the comic tales my mother told. I wonder why she did that.
Doggerel to amuse children, I see.
No. Something more. I read this storybook to my son long ago.
Gorgoroth fouls earth and sky, plows a path of flame. Haste, haste, haste! It rages across land, scorches a path.
Tar-Goroth will not be difficult to find.
Burns. It burns all.
Oh, I can't dismount.
Escape me this Tar-Goroth. Please, Mordor, to burn your lands.
That's cruel. Send me in a path of things I can't collect.
Death is what you seek! He must be buried. He must be returned to the depths.
Tracks. No.
It's doubled back.
Lies in wait to rain down fire.
Where are we going?
To ice. We go to ice.
Thank you.
What did he say?
Does it matter?
This Balrog is from another world.
It is up to us now, Talion.
This isn't working!
Send this beast to the depths.
Send this beast to the death.
I never dared to break the seal on this scroll, though I often wanted to. I found it in a dust-covered box with a label marked Maps of Southron Trade Routes. Baranor is a Haradrim. So perhaps this scroll has a map of his homeland. Breaking the seal is strictly forbidden for those who aren't lords of Gondor. And as much as I'm curious, I know my father would not approve.
Did you ever travel to the Southern Lands?
There is little there that interests me, and few who go there return.
Didn't even introduce himself.
We will conquer Sauron!
As you wish, Bright Lord. One thing about Gondor is, kneel before me!
Well, shit, can't even unlock the fast travel point.
Well, that's dinosaur head.
Okay. Nice. Let's go. There we go. It's a buggy ass game. Fun, but buggy as shit.
Look at the man, Bill. Nice deal. On your knees.
And that should be it for Intel. Great, another cave.
These Ologs are pillars of the War Chief's forces. Topple them.
Stop moving!
is going to hurt even more!
Why can I not brutalize? In stealth kill?
Slit your throat!
I want to dominate my own guy who's over there, not the guy directly in front of me. Person for my army.
I can smell. sneak.
The Ranger!
The lamps of Eregion illuminate a room with a soft glow, one that leaves only the most tenuous of shadows, a light that seems willing to turn corners and reach further than it ought. When we stored these lamps in the Great Hall, I would light them for an evening every midwinter just to ensure they still functioned. They cheered me so much that I always resolved to do so more often, but then I'd forget or put it off. How I miss their light now.
I know you're close.
I fashioned these lamps and gave them to the dwarves of Moria.
And they've traveled very far indeed. But in whose hands?
I know you're close.
The champion regarded warfare as an art form, and himself as Mordor's greatest artist. Making him my war chief meant pricking his overweening pride.
Shocking the title, I see. This is garden variety carnage. Mediocre. Sharpen your blade, intruder. Then test yourself against Mordor's champion.
Thank you.
fancy yourself a true warrior, do you? You may be flashy with a blade, but I'm not so easily impressed. Your technique has flaws, and I'm about to show them to you.
We're going to kill him or what? So it falls to me to put you down. Typical. I have to do everything else around here.
Come on, I was in the middle of a ground execution. What the fuck? I countered! Double what the fuck. These missions are so fucking frustrating.
The champion regarded warfare as an art form, and himself as Mordor's greatest artist. Making him my war chief meant pricking his overweening pride.
Yeah.
Someone wants a shot at the title, I see. This is garden variety carnage. Mediocre. Sharpen your blade, intruder. Then test yourself against Mordor's champion! A true warrior, do you? You may be flashy with a blade, but I'm not so easily impressed. Your technique has flaws, and I'm about to show them to you.
Move, Luke. Use my stealth. He should be dazed over stealth
attack. He's not here to talk. He's here to tear you apart. And I'm here to spit on your remains.
Looks like I'll have to be the one who kills you today.
Yes, that's exactly who I wanted to do that to.
Yeah.
Chosen Master!
Chosen Master!
Few orcs could stand toe-to-toe with the champion and live to count their scars. Sending him into the fray was as simple as posing a challenge. Many an able warrior can be so manipulated. This war chief is cunning. We must gain more information before we engage him.
His wings bring him flight. But at what cost? The cost to those around him. The cost to himself. The time has come for this debt to be paid. Death's wings beat, and its eyes are focused squarely on you.
Oh!
to run over!
Tremble before me! Serve me!
I serve the Bright Lord! Lord! If I must, it's getting annoying!
Jesus! We got you now! Tired of things sneaking about!
Men and orcs have clashed for centuries. In living memory, the greatest battle between them took place near Long Lake, where men, aided by elves and dwarves, battled the orcs and goblins of Moria. The free folk won the day, and some accounts claim that eagles of the Misty Mountains swooped down onto the battlefield, casting the orcs down from the cliffs and mountains where they stood. Seems a fanciful tale. I saw no eagles overhead when Minas Ithil fell, though we did have Talion and his strange powers. We would have welcomed aid from anywhere, even the skies.
The eagles of the Misty Mountains are more than a myth.
Perhaps, but I doubt they'd fare well against the drakes I've seen.
I've never seen a warg, but books and traveling hunters have told me plenty. The goblins of the north can ride wargs as the men of Rohan ride horses. Their howls can be heard leagues away, and their senses are keen enough to track even a ranger. What makes a warg truly fearsome is that they hunt in packs of a dozen or more. Catagors are more dangerous, but they travel in smaller numbers. A feeble blessing, that.
I'm glad they don't range into Mordor.
Even a pack of wargs would find survival here difficult.
This artifact was a gift from Gondor's other frontier, the long beaches of Unfalas along Gondor's distant shores. Their lord, Galazgil, sent us this ceremonial bowl with water from the River Morthond, and we kept the bowl long after the water had evaporated. I've often daydreamed of visiting Unfalas. I think I'd like it better than the capital city of Minas Tirith. There is too much of the frontier within me to be happy living in settled lands.
This bowl is far from home.
As are we all, Celebrimbor.
Yeah.
What's that noise?
And crush, crush, and crush!
Glad I discovered his betrayal here and not in a critical moment. I need new bodyguard.
Argul.
There was a certain pleasure in serving you, but there are so many other things I can do with you. To derive pleasure!
Time for the boom!
Don't be serious. I've had worse from crippled ghouls.
Let's go!
Biggie there didn't give me much of a chance to dominate him. Consume didn't work.
He's frozen!
You will recommend.
No new replacements.
Of the distant north have long been named among Gondor's allies, though I've never seen one in person. This cloak is as light as the morning fog on the shoulders. I tried it on once, and its colors seem to shift and blend as the light changes. How meager the product of our looms is when compared to elven handiwork.
I recognize this cloak. It is of my people.
A people we see precious few signs of in this land.
There is another worm we must intercept.
What message does he carry?
Orders for three captains to report to the Chosen Ritual. He'll pass through this camp.
But he's going to find it curiously empty.
Most Gondorians, this midnight urn is a simple pot of clay, but to the denizens of Minas Ithil, it represented shared sacrifice that only those who live on the frontier understand. For centuries, the name of every able-bodied resident of Minas Ithil was placed in the midnight urn, and at sunset, a name was drawn. That person would have to patrol the city's walls until sunrise. The task was ceremonial once we had a professional army. But that made it no less important. From our earliest days, it was always a neighbor watching from the walls. I was 10 the first time they drew my name, and I've never been prouder, though I could barely see over the parapet.
Why leave the defense of your walls to chance?
It isn't about chance. It's about unity. Everyone's names are mixed together, and everyone takes a turn on the wall.
These worms move under guard. I'll move to high ground to eliminate the escorts.
Not all of them.
We'll see, Ranger. Gondor's artisans rival the elves in their dedication, if not their skill. None more so than our weavers. Paint on a wall or canvas will fade in time, but thread retains its vibrant color for centuries. The Numenoreans taught our people the art of the loom generations ago, and it is a talent we've nurtured ever since.
I wonder where this was intended to hide.
Wherever it was, I doubt it still stands. Only the strongest fortresses last long here.
Here they come!
Are you just seeing them now? This will be easier than I thought.
Are you deciding whom I let live?
Just get the information.
Where are the captains who would become chosen?
They're coming from the fort! They should be here shortly!
Seems our friends are eager to meet us.
Good. Our friendly competition is not over yet.
Fremen.
To become one of the chosen! And you can't stop me!
Shut it! Let's kill him!
Stop counting!
Join the army!
To be chosen!
That's three captains who will not become chosen. But there is no shortage of recruits to take their place.
Any who are selected we will target. If we cannot yet stop the Nazgul, we will slow them down.
I don't know if the future is written or unwritten. My mind could travel up and down these paths, and they were like memories. But like memory, the mind would shape them to suit its ends. Were these my fears or my hopes? It takes a cold eye to see the future for what it is.
Are these not the same dangers as the Palantir, the Hydir?
There is a risk in all these things, but wars are not won by the cautious.
Great walker!
The Orcs are neither the only denizens of Mordor, nor the first. Easterlings and Harrodrum have settled here from time to time, often at the Dark Lord's invitation. They are scarce today, but one can still find their strange artistic carvings scattered in places from Nern to the city of the Corsairs.
An artifact of the Harrodrim. Interesting.
Few find their way this far north, and for that, your nation should be grateful.
Minas Ithil is on Gondor's frontier. So we have few occasions for the grand balls and masquerades that are surely common events in the capital city. Fine dresses like this one are worn for ceremony, funerals and weddings mostly, not for lordly entertainment. I wonder if the noble families of Minas Tirith spared a thought for us, holding all of Mordor at bay while they danced.
Away.
Who in Mordor would wear such a thing in days like these?
Rich people.
You made it!
Giggity. I'm hoping this will leave you too.
Make misery of their sport.
You kill my beastie, I kill you!
I think we made them angry.
So much to them.
Deal with these orcs first.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Mordor is but the beginning. Even Middle-earth will not satisfy him.
Oh, at least it brought me back right here.
Everywhere for you.
And I you.
Come. I'll escort you to Heneth Anu. You'll be safe there.
No. I'm not leaving Mordor. Not till all of our brothers are free.
Come now. We will speak of this later.
My father sacrificed all of Minas Ithil for my safety. I will not be protected any longer. Not by you. Not by anyone.
Idril, you will die out here.
Then that is my fate. But I'm staying. Go. Reinforcements will be here soon. We will meet again.
All right, break time.